I'm gonna show you guys 24 hours of my life. It is midnight right now. My dog is sleeping right here. I'm gonna leave the house, start my day. Step one, heading to a TV station right now. Fox 11 in Los Angeles. Gonna get some coffee and hit the road. Okay guys, it's 3 a.m. I'm here at Fox 11 News in Los Angeles. Here's the weather wall. Here's where the anchors sit, the studio, helping them get ready for the morning show. And the day is just starting. We're rocking and rolling. Here's the green room. The green room where all the guests are. Nobody's here right now, obviously. Makeup, hair. Many times they do interviews against this wall over here. This is the behind the scenes. All right guys, done at the TV station. 6:58 in the morning. Time to go home for a couple hours. Then head to Riverside, and then from there to Vegas for the fights tonight, then back to LA. We're staying busy. I'm thinking of Muhammad Ali saying, don't count the days, make the days count. And that's exactly what we're doing. So we were here, morning show went great. Now it's time to go cover some boxing. Keep it moving. So now it's 9:20, time to hit the road, go to Riverside. Just uploaded some videos, played a little bit with the dog, gave her some food. Hi, Delilah. Say hi. Okay, she knows I'm going. Bye, Delilah. It takes me about 2 hours to get to RGBA, and that's without traffic. I get on 7 freeways. So we're hitting the road right now, and then meeting up with Chepe and with Payo. They are driving. Robert, Pita are already in Vegas. Of course, Joshua Franco fighting tonight for the championship. There's a police car, so I better put down my phone. While on the way to Riverside, every day I get calls from celebrities. On this day, I spoke to Baby Bash, recording artist, one of the best in the planet and a huge, huge boxing fan.
Yeah, I'm just checking in with you, man. See when you go back to Roberts.
Okay.
Back in LA for a while.
All right, cool, cool, cool. So right now, I'm actually on my way there because they're all driving to Vegas today and driving back the same day. One of the guys who's fighting tonight on ESPN, his name is Joshua Franco. He has 19 fights. He's fighting the champion from Australia named Andrew Maloney.
And, oh, yeah, I heard of him. Today's Tuesday, right? They're doing Tuesday, right?
Yep. And this is actually a really good fight. Like, you know, it's for the championship. It's legit.
Yeah, wow. The other one's been so weak, one-sided, dude. I don't like that one-sided shit.
Yeah, it's look, UFC, I'm not the biggest UFC fan. I like the UFC fighters, but they're at least put on quality fights back to back.
Yeah.
After the phone call from Baby Bash, I made it to the camp house in Riverside. Check it out.
Hector Tanahara, we're heading to Vegas. You're coming?
Yeah, ready.
Let's go. We made it here. This is Gaylord Fucker, known as George. This is the camp house. This is Louis. He's recovering from his surgery. He got jumped by a few dogs.
He's been in the war.
All right, so what time is it right now, Hector?
12:12
is Hector, Chepe, Chef.
What's up?
Chan in the house. We're driving to Vegas.
Mission, baby.
We'll get there by 3. Josh fights like 6. How long have you known Joshua Franklin?
I've known him probably 2011. I remember when he first started boxing.
It's a long time.
Yeah, he was... I was already boxing at the gym, and then he started boxing. So I've seen him since he started boxing. That's when I know him. And now, I used to stay at his house and stuff growing up.
Why you stay at his house?
Just because we were little. That's what we would do and stuff. Chill.
He's a good kid. Good nature. Good person. I mean, not kid. Yeah. And now you'll be there tonight where he's fighting. Here you go. Thank you.
Yeah, his whole family is good people. And then,
he's fighting for the world title.
Yeah, it's crazy.
It's
a good feeling because, you know, I've known him the whole time, and now he's fighting for world title, something that every boxer dreams about.
You're 19-0. So what's your guys' prediction for the fight tonight?
I think Josh is gonna beat him, whoop him.
Trap it. Take a left. I predict. I think Josh is gonna. He's gonna beat this guy up and maybe a late stoppage.
Yeah, I think.
Chef.
Maybe a late stoppage. Late stoppage.
Or decision.
I think so too.
Decision, but
even if Josh catches.
I'm going towards the stoppage, man. Josh is in really, really good shape.
He's in the best shape he's ever been. Even Hector's in the best shape he's ever been.
Yep.
Hey, doing strength and conditioning with Coach Charles and with Chepa makes a big difference.
Yeah, it really does. This is honestly the best I've ever felt in my career so far. So I know Josh is ready because I've been working out with Charles and it's been real good.
Right there. He's ready mentally and physically. You got to be ready mentally too. Got to be in a happy place and he's very happy.
Yeah, he's in a good place right now. Focused.
So here we are.
I've been hyped since last night.
He's a 2-1 underdog right now. He was 6-1.
7-1.
7-1. Sorry.
7.5. Yesterday, I didn't sleep till like 1, just thinking about it, watching fights and shit.
Josh came out in Forbes boxing odds. Andrew Maloney versus Joshua Franklin.
Yeah, because everybody was betting on Joshua. They had to like change the odds. Yeah. Hey, will Spino be there tonight? We need to hit him up. Make sure he swings by.
Oh, I'll text him right now. I'm sure.
Yeah. Espino doesn't have a fight yet either, right?
No, he doesn't.
So, Hector, what's the latest with you and Ryan? Is this going to happen, you and Ryan Garcia?
I don't think it's going to happen. But hopefully I should be getting a fight soon. Hopefully. End of July.
Anybody want to fight? Or anybody can get it?
Anybody can get it. Just hope real soon, you know, get a
title shot or something. Big fight.
That'd be cool. So, are you a little nervous right now?
I honestly get more nervous when my boys fight than when I fight. So yeah, I'm a little anxious, a little fucking just it's exciting.
Frank the Cook said that I look like a crackhead when I watch boxing because you know I'm following the motions as they're throwing. Is there you know you?
Man, I'd be jumping all over the place when my friends are fighting.
You're doing a shoulder roll right now.
Yeah, I know. I'd be like all over the place.
Yeah.
She when Louis fought. Oh my god.
2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
I was
he did so good excited.
Before
extra mile right now. It's 113 degrees outside. I think you could cook an egg in 113 degrees.
Oh my god.
So this is the swimming pool here at the MGM. Life is good. Oh, that's the waitress. It's 113 degrees outside. The pool is the right place to be right now.
Oh my god,
that's gonna be you.
Crazy.
That's gonna be you after your fight.
No, but that's crazy. There's no corona.
Nah. There's no Rona.
No Rona, we're not here.
So we just drove all the way from Riverside. Fight night, Joshua Franco. You'll see a lot of fights here on the wall. Chepe, what are the odds right now of Joshua Franco here?
If Joshua wins by knockout, it's plus 1,000 right now.
So you bet 100, you get 1,000 back?
Is that
what you're going to do?
Most likely, yes.
Chef, are you going to do the same?
I'm good, man.
Hector, you don't gamble, so we're not going to ask you. Fighters don't gamble. He's very focused.
But I would say if you're going to bet the house on Josh.
Bet 100. All right. There you have it. So guys, should I do the bet? Stay tuned. At least take back. Reporting. Well, right now it's about 5:30. The fights have started. On the phone with us, Eric DeLeon. He came to check in how Joshua Franco's doing. What goes through your mind?
I'm excited. I can't wait. I know he's been training hard his whole life for this. It's his time to shine. I know he's going to get that strap.
What's your prediction really quick?
Either late knockout or unanimous decision. Uh-huh. Joshua Franco.
There you have it. Eric DeLeon. Eric, tell people where to follow you and what's next for you.
You can follow me on Instagram at Team DeLeon 1 or Twitter, Team DeLeon 3, Golden DeLeon 313.
By the way,
Hoping to get a big fight before the end of the summer.
Hey, Ellie, really quick?
Yeah.
If the Salvation Army calls me for it, it's one of my side pieces, right?
Okay. He said if the Salvation Army calls him, it's one of his side pieces. But back to the interview. Teofimo Lopez against Lomachenko. You sparred Lomachenko. Break down the fight.
Lomachenko's a beast, but Teofimo's so strong right now. I think it's going to be a good fight, but it could go either way. But, you know, You guys can't miss that fight. I'm excited for it. I guess it's going to be late September, so I'm excited. I can't wait.
All right, there you have it, Eric.
That's Pauly Malignaggi Jr.
It's 7:30 at night. Hector, Joshua Franco is about to walk out. You got Pio, you got Chef. What's up, George? How's your day been?
Fucking going great, going great. Let's fucking get this W.
I'm gonna be yelling like I'm in the motherfucker.
Get this W.
There's more people here than in the venue.
Here we go.
We're here for Josh. We're here for Josh.
Round two, Joshua Franco Maloney.
He felt that shit.
Okay, we're entering round three. Is it 1-1 so far? 1-1? Got a superstar in the house. Alexis Pino came to support Joshua Franco here in the bleachers. Great round for Josh. This is round five.
Fucking future champ right here.
Hey, the doctor should have stopped the fight. He's gonna go straight to the hospital. Great job.
No fucking wash up their fucking fighter. 13. Number 13. ¿Cuántos, güey? ¿Cuántos payo?
Josh.
Yeah! There's only one. There's only one. It's gonna be a fun ride back home.
It'll be even more back home.
So everybody here drove up to support. Everyone came to support Joshua Franco. You came to support your homie?
Yeah.
Where did we park?
It's crazy. I can't believe it. I can't believe it. Joyce.
Hey, bam in the house.
I fucking told you. I fucking told you.
What did you tell him? What did you tell him?
I told him.
Hey, record it.
I told him. I told him.
That's what I'm talking about, Josh.
You fucking deserve this shit. You deserve this shit. Enjoy this shit.
And the new.
And the new.
Hey, almost got robbed.
They wanted to.
Look, a draw. He keeps the belt.
If it wasn't for the knockdown, yeah.
Robert, he dominated. Maybe the other guy won two rounds, maybe three. Yeah. If I'm generous. Yes. Pita, you're down. Good job. How are you feeling?
Fucking, I don't know.
Hey, Robert. A lot of people here bet a lot of money on the knockout. Tony Weeks fucked us over.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, a lot. The knockout, if you bet $100, you get back $1,000.
Oh, shit.
How's it going? What do you guys say about the fight?
It was good. He did so good.
Let's see the belt. What do you think? How did he do?
I'm very happy. He did very good.
He dominated. So how does it feel to be a world champ? You dreamt about this since you were 9 years old?
Yeah, it's crazy. I don't know, man. Words can't describe how I feel, honestly.
What a great performance. From start to finish, a clinic.
Right now, when we come down, tell Pio to meet us by the elevator. Tell to meet us by the elevator.
Yeah, I'll show you guys. I'll show you guys. So, Pete, a message to your fans if they're watching?
Not mine, Justice.
What message to your fans?
Thank you for the support. I knew we would do it. I'm world champion now.
Okay, who do you want next?
I have a rematch clause with Maloney.
Okay, who do you want next?
I have a rematch clause with Maloney, but you know, I'll
he's not gonna take this.
Get him out the way, and then whoever.
Well, we have a rematch clause, so we have to.
Robert,
have
check
to
this out. Rematch. He was a 10-1 underdog. They thought they counted him out.
They still try to rob us.
13 champions.
If it wasn't for that fucking knockdown, it would have been a draw. I can't believe that shit.
I know, but that's boxing.
But we got the win. That's the
win. Hey, you did it. On short notice. Do you see the message you got from Mikey, from Virgil, from Oscar De La Hoya?
Yeah, that shit was badass.
Yeah, that shit was badass.
That's badass. So a lot of people came, so we were watching it at the sports book, driving everybody crazy. We were loud.
Yeah.
It was cool. I seen the video.
I saw the video.
It was fun. All right, guys. We'll see you by the fountain in a few minutes.
Let's go up there. Meet us by the elevator, all right? I put an elevator, right?
All right, we'll see you by the elevator. Congratulations.
Thanks, Eli.
All right, you're welcome. What were you guys singing after the fight when you left the venue? Pray and go. Pray and go. Everybody, I won $100, but Tony Weeks messed me over.
I didn't bet. I don't bet on it.
Hey, did that?
Did
you know? Hey, by the way, they should have stopped the fight in the 10th round, 11th, because Mahoney left on a stretcher.
He should have not done that. He started throwing up after.
Should have not done that.
They took him to the hospital.
That's when you get a concussion. Yeah. I hope he's okay.
Yeah, we hope he's okay.
So Robert, what did you tell Joshua in the corner between rounds?
Got to motivate him. Got to motivate him. You know, it was just motivation right there. We knew the fight was ours. We just had to motivate him.
You told him have fun. He looked good. Hey, I like the uppercut. I like the punches to the body. Overhand right.
He got down. That shit was sick.
Now the scorecards terrible. Yeah, very bad scorecards. Espino, get in. But we don't know the rest of the words.
We'll learn them.
Hey, where's the belt? Joshua, where's the belt at?
Give it back to the champ.
Give it back?
Yeah, we got to give it back.
We're going to send him here.
Yeah, my girl. Yeah, all right.
Living in the Brinko one. Wow, whose blood is that?
That's all the other guys.
Joshua! Josh! Josh, whose blood is that?
Maloney.
How was it to be in there? How was it to win a title?
It was crazy, man. I knew I had it in the bag. I just had to keep pushing and I was fucking him up.
You
did great. You put San Antonio on the map.
Yeah.
Hey, is your phone blowing up right now?
Yeah.
How many messages? Without showing us, but what are people writing you? Like, who's contacting you? Everybody's blowing me up from all over the world.
It's just my social media.
And what are they saying? How many new followers you get?
Look, I'm already at 6,000. I'm about to be at 7,000.
Just like that?
Just like that.
That's what it takes. Well, listen, they didn't believe in you. They doubted you. You came in as a major underdog, and you pulled it off.
Yep.
Hey, but what do you say about everybody who came here to support you? From your family, your friends?
I love everybody that came to support me. This is all my
family. How many fights
have
I been to support you already?
Hey, can I ask you a question? When you were kids and he stayed at your house, why did you and your brother terrorize him? That's what I want to know.
They're my homies.
Yeah, we go way back.
Listen, he was very nervous. He was very excited, but he was very happy for you.
Nervous. Hell yeah.
What did your brother tell you when you hugged him after the fight?
He just told me that he was proud of me, and he knew I was going to do it, that I'm his role model. made me cry.
George got emotional. He started crying with tears. Well, good. Congratulations. Message to your fans.
I caught a moment that can't be unseen. That's why.
Franco, message to the fans.
Thank you for the support.
Pita Garcia.
See you soon.
Pita, good job. Pita, really quick, before you go, hey. Talk to the fans really quick on the line. Talk to them, Pita, they might have questions.
Who said there's no audience? We're driving back, and there's all the audience from the Josh Franco fight. Everybody's driving back from Vegas. Everybody came to support him.
I didn't see them.
I saw them. This is on a Tuesday night. You're from Vegas. You never see traffic like this. It's all Joshua Franco.
Never. This is all Joshua Franco.
While we were driving back, my phone rang. Omar Benson Miller from Ballers, from 8 Mile. He was on the phone talking boxing, talking to Hector Tanahara.
Did you guys watch the fight tonight?
Yeah, we were we made the drive from Riverside over here to Vegas to just to watch the fight and see just to watch the fight. I grew up with Josh
from San Antonio.
Yeah, from Frank. Me and him grew up together.
Oh, that's what's up.
Yeah, I was in the gym when. Appreciate that. Yeah, so I grew up with him. So it was a good feeling being here with him. Yeah.
You know, Omar is good friends with everybody at Golden Boy.
Oh, for
real? Hector's a Golden Boy fighter, 19-0.
Okay, but bust it, man. I'm telling you, I'm telling you from my own personal experience in real life, it's great when you see your friend succeed like that because it's so close, you know? You can almost touch it. It's so close. And then it's bam. The next thing you know, it's your turn up and it's your turn to execute.
Yeah,
so,
exactly.
Man, that's great for you guys.
Yeah, exactly. How you saying? I feel like it's my turn next. I was working with him this whole camp, so yeah, it's like it's a surreal feeling.
Yeah, bro. I know the feeling well. I got the call to be in 8 Mile when I was on the floor of my mom's junior one-bedroom apartment, bro. And I know exactly what that feeling is like. And then shortly after that, I was on the first-class flight. First time I'd ever been on a first-class flight. Meeting up with Eminem changed my life, man. You down with Ellie, and it's all good.
Yes, sir. I'll follow you right now.
Hey, I want you to say hello to right here. You have a fighter. He's going to be a super champion. He's, 168?
160.
Alexis Espino, he's from Vegas and he trains with Robert. He fights in the zone. Say hello to Omar.
What's up, Omar? Yeah, my name's Woody. I already told you I'm 6-0. I'm just coming up. I'm 6-0 with 4 knockouts. And coming up. Straight up, little by little, man.
That's it. So where do you guys train? You train with Robert out in Moreno Valley?
Riverside, yeah.
Yeah. That's what's up.
Hey, Omar.
Every time I pass by there, because my pops lives in the desert, every time I pass by there, I say, well, stop by. I gotta go over there and stop in the gym.
Hell yeah, man. That'd be sick.
Last time I stopped in the gym was when Gino was training for me with it.
Yeah.
Some other dude that was my size that wanted to mix it up.
That's true. Yeah, no. Thanks so much for calling. I appreciate it. Really quick, say hello to Chepe, the strength coach. He works with everybody.
What's up, Omar? Whenever you want to get a good boxing session and strength conditioning session, head over to RGPA to Riverside, man.
I love it.
All right, for sure.
Well, y'all dudes have a safe drive.
Thank you so much. All right, we'll talk soon.
Happy birthday, Ellie. I'll talk to you soon.
All right, back from Vegas at the fighter's house. How do you summarize, Chepe? Thanks for driving. Chef Chan, how do you summarize the whole trip, the whole evening, the whole day?
It was a badass day.
Success.
And look who you guys brought with you guys.
Success.
The star is here. Alexis, how do we all fit in a car with space?
I don't know how the hell we did it, but
long day.
Made it, long day.
Joshua got down. Two, I've been up for 26 hours now.
Wow,
we're not done yet. We still have to go home.
Got the world title. We all
right.
Tell him where you live.
All right. Do I need to close the gate when I leave?
Yes.
Okay. All right. I'll see you guys maybe tomorrow.
See German Shepherds here. Yes.
So they don't hit the road. All right. Reporting. So guys, this journey almost over, 27 hours on the road. We started at midnight last night and now it's 3 in the morning the following day. Joshua Franco did what he had to do, won the championship, and it was phenomenal. Congratulations, Joshua Franco. This is where it all started at midnight yesterday, 3:27. Back home, Delilah's happy. Come on, Delilah, come. Good girl, hi. Good girl. Delilah. All right. Hope you guys enjoyed the videos. Hope you got a little insight of what it's like to cover a fight for a 24-hour period during this time until things come back. So there you have it. Congratulations, Joshua Franco. He got down, and now he's a world champion. Congratulations to RGBA, Robert Garcia's 13th world champion. So there you have it. Stay tuned for usnewsreporting.com. I'm Ali Zekback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Zekback. You can follow me on Instagram, @LEZekback.